From disgusting foot ulcers to gangrenous toes that fall off, these are the most horrific things that could happen to your feet. Number 10. Diabetic foot. Diabetes mellitus is a chronic disease that slowly affects many of the body's organs and systems. Very commonly, it affects the lower limbs in the form of nerve damage, infection, and impaired blood supply to the feet. Collectively, this is known as diabetic foot. A high blood glucose level impairs the feet's nervous system, leading to a loss of sensory and pain sensation, so the person becomes unaware of the injury sustained there. This is further complicated by the impaired blood flow, making healing very slow and difficult. When the sore is left open and unhealed for long periods, it becomes easily infected, and the pathogens take advantage of the body's poor immune system to further proliferate. Diabetic foot lesions usually start as ulcers or open sores at the toes, sole, or heel of the patient. Since their sense of pain at the feet is impaired, they tend to ignore these lesions until it becomes worse. But when severe infection and gangrene sets in, no amount of medicine or surgical debridement would heal it, and the only solution would be amputation. But even cutting off the foot might not be enough in the long run, as diabetes is a chronic, lifelong disease, and the patients might end up with further amputations all the way above the knee in the future. Number 9. Club foot. Club foot is an unfortunate congenital deformity to be born with. It is fairly common, affecting 1 in 1,000 people. The condition can affect either one or both feet, making them twisted internally at the ankle. Without treatment, people with club feet would appear to painfully stagger and walk on their ankles or sides of their feet. Fortunately, the condition could be corrected rather easily nowadays through the use of braces, physiotherapy, and surgery. American actor Damon Wayans was born with a clubbed foot and lived with it for years before undergoing surgical correction. Before that, his deformity was often teased by other kids. It was one of the things that brought him into comedy, using humor to combat pain. This attribute was later given to the main character in Waynehead, a cartoon series that Wayan created based on his own childhood, about a poor boy with a club foot. Number 8. Proteus Syndrome. Proteus syndrome is an extremely rare congenital disorder that results in bone, skin, and tissue overgrowth. The underlying cause is a genetic mutation in the AKT1 gene, which regulates the growth and division of cells. There has only been around 200 cases ever recorded, and currently only 120 people on the planet are alive with the condition. Jeffrey Ortega from Florida is one of them. He was diagnosed with Proteus syndrome when he was just a baby, after his parents brought him to the hospital when they noticed that his left leg was a little longer than his right. As he grew up, his feet began developing abnormal growths underneath the soles, which then spread to the sides. At the age of 11, he stopped wearing regular shoes, as none of them could fit him. Today, at the age of 27, his left foot has reached 14 inches in length, with a circumference of 17 inches. His right foot is relatively smaller. Walking itself is painful and difficult for Ortega, and he is now seeking to amputate his left foot, believing it would improve his general well-being. Number 7. Psoriasis of the foot. Psoriasis is an autoimmune disease that affects the skin, characterized by the formation of plaques and scales. It can affect almost any surface of the body, but are commonly seen at the elbows, knees, back, scalp, and feet. Psoriasis of the foot presents as thickening and yellowing at the sole and sides, often accompanied by pustules and abscesses. The condition is unpleasant and painful, and causes severe discomfort upon standing or walking. Further progression of psoriasis can lead to psoriatic arthritis, which affects the foot even further. It is a very destructive and painful type of arthritis, which erodes the joints and makes them swell. The distal joints of the smaller toes are mostly affected. Toenails could be affected as well, becoming separated from their underlying nail beds. Number 6. Lymphedema Stage 3. The lymphatic system is a network of vessels that run throughout the entire body, parallel to the blood circulatory system. It carries the body's interstitial fluid towards the heart and into the bloodstream, and functions as part of the immune system. But when this system is compromised and the lymphatic vessels become blocked, it results in a gruesome condition in the lower limbs, known as lymphedema. Lymphedema of the lower limbs can be caused by multiple reasons, one of the main being parasitic infection, specifically filarial worms. These worms occupy the lymphatic system, causing a blockage, so interstitial fluid becomes accumulated in the legs. Left untreated, the feet and legs would continue to swell from accumulated fluid and eventually reach an irreversible state known as lymphedema stage 3. At this stage, the feet and legs are horribly disfigured, having swelled to an enormous size, making them practically useless. The range of movements of the legs is severely limited, and they are often too heavy to properly walk with. Because of its appearance, the condition is sometimes called elephantitis, referring to an elephant's leg. The leg tissues have hardened and are unresponsive to medication, and some people resort to debulk it via reconstructive surgery. However, this practice is dangerous and could harm the patient more, with complications like added bacterial infections. Number 5. Podoconiosis, aka mossy foot. Like the aforementioned elephantitis caused by filarial worms, this condition is somewhat similar, but differs in its cause. Podoconiosis, or mossy foot, is a case of lymphedema affecting the lower limbs due to repeated exposure to irritant soils. Like filarial elephantitis, podoconiosis is characterized by immense swelling of the feet and legs, leading to disfigurement and disability. Evidence has suggested that some people are prone to develop inflammatory reactions upon chronic skin exposure to silicate and mineral particles present in red clay soils. Since podoconiosis only develops upon direct skin contact with soil, the condition is prevalent in Africa and third world countries where many people walk barefoot. It is also more commonly seen in higher altitude areas with volcanic soil rich in silica irritants. The appearance of podoconiosis is not a pleasant one. Multiple nodules and wart-like growths develop over time, resembling moss. The swelling is hideous, and the pain and discomfort makes it difficult for the sufferer to walk. It gets worse with recurrent infection, resulting in a terrible stench. Sufferers are sometimes ostracized and shunned by ignorant communities thinking they are cursed, and are forced to become beggars. Number 4. Onychocryptosis, aka ingrown toenail. Onychocryptosis, or ingrown nails, are very common and seen in all ages, but are more commonly seen in children whose toe structure undergo inconsistent growth, or in old people due to structural bone changes. Other reasons include improper cutting of the toenails, wearing tight footwear, and stress. Ingrown toenails might sound like a trivial matter, but aren't something that should be ignored. The nail could penetrate deep into the flesh and cause intense pain and inflammation at the site where it curls into. This also increases the chance for infection, resulting in further damage to the toe. In 2012, English teacher Hannah Moore had surgery to remove an ingrown toenail on her right foot after experiencing months of discomfort. It was a minor operation, and no complications were expected. However, days later, she developed complex regional pain syndrome, a rare and extremely agonizing condition. Her foot turned dark, and a horrible flesh-eating ulcer appeared in the middle of it. Even the slightest touch to the leg caused unbearable pain. After more than 3 years of suffering, she decided to get rid of the foot altogether. In July 2016, Hannah underwent a surgery to have her right leg amputated, all because of one ingrown toenail. Number 3. Osteomyelitis of the foot. Osteomyelitis is an infection of a bone that is usually caused by the Staphylococcus bacteria. Bones rarely become infected, although it does happen in a number of ways. Most commonly, the bacterium gets in via the bloodstream or following an injury, particularly to the foot or ankle. Osteomyelitis of the bones of the feet might become suppurative, with the formation of pus deep inside the bone's blood vessels. When it gets chronic, the bones become sclerosed and deformed. In these late stages, the only solution is surgical drainage of pus and the removal of dead and infected bones. If the infection persists, amputation of the foot or leg might become necessary. Number 2. The wrong leg being amputated. foot or leg amputations are common procedures done in hospitals, and it is sometimes unthinkable that a surgeon could mess up so badly by cutting off the wrong limb. Yet that mistake does happen. And of course, having the wrong foot or leg amputated still means you require the correct amputation, so you end up with both sides gone. In 1995, one of the most shocking and publicized medical mistakes of the century happened in the University Community Hospital in Tampa, Florida. The then 52-year-old Willie King was wheeled into the operation theater to remove a diseased leg. But during the procedure, surgeons accidentally cut the wrong leg and did not realize their mistake until it was too late to reverse the procedure. According to the hearing, it was a series of mistakes that led to the wrong leg being prepped for surgery, and the surgeons claimed that both legs were in fact unhealthy. However, the mistake still cost the attending surgeon a large sum of money and fines, as well as a 6-month suspension from practicing medicine. Number 1. Critical limb ischemia of the lower limbs. Peripheral arteries that supply the limbs could become narrowed from years of cholesterol buildup, cigarette smoking, and high blood pressure. The initial symptom would be intermittent claudication, described as intense muscle pain during activities, usually in the calf muscles. Progressive worsening would eventually lead to critical limb ischemia, the most advanced and terrifying outcome of a peripheral artery disease. At this stage, patients would often experience continuous severe burning pains of the lower leg and feet, even during rest. Insufficient blood supply due to narrowed arteries would eventually lead to tissue death in the form of ulcers and gangrene. The ulcers, which have a punched-out appearance, are intensely painful and have a chance of becoming infected. The gangrenous tissues are even worse. Due to limited oxygen in the ischemic limb, the affected parts, normally the toes, become dry, shrunken, and black, with a clear line of separation from the non-gangrenous part. These dead tissues have no chance of being cured, and if not removed surgically, would eventually detach and fall off by itself automatically. Jeff the Killer's disfigured face is the most familiar image in the creepypasta universe. The story is about a teenage boy's descent into murderous madness. Most of the times, the story involves a young boy named Jeff who moves into a new neighborhood with his younger brother Lou and his parents.